Hello, welcome to lab 8. So we will continue with the text functions today. And as I said earlier, that we could find it in this ribbon here on the top. There is an insert ribbon, page layout, formulas. In formulas, if you look, there is a set of text functions, and the text functions can be seen here. We can see a list of text functions, and it's a good way to explore new functions by going through this list here, trying out each one of them. If you don't know a particular function, for instance, we don't know what is the purpose of, let's say, the replace function, then we could click replace and a help pops out, and we can see replaces part of a text string with a different text string. So we'll try that out, but we can take help and use help to understand these functions better. So now let's continue from the earlier one. If you remember, if I want to extract the first name from this column, if I want to get the first name out of the column, I need to find the space. And how do we find the space? We use the find command. We say, what text am I finding? I'm looking for the space, comma, and where am I looking for? In the name itself. Close the bracket, tab, and the space is there in the 8th position. And how did we take out the first name last time? We had done a concept of left, and we selected the string, and we have to say 8 minus 1, 7 characters we need. So we'll click on this, subtract 1, close the bracket, and we got the first name. Now I'd given us a challenge question, how do we find the surname? Now to find the surname, first we need to find that length, because what we really need is to take the last 3 characters in the case of Jibrail Jose, the last 5 characters of Gupta, and the last 5 characters of Singh. So due to which, ideally we need the length first. And length can be got by the len function, and it tells me the length is 11. So now, the space is in the 8th position, length is 11. So how many characters do we need from the right? We need 11 minus 8, 3 characters. In the case of Aman Gupta, we need 10 minus 5 from the end. So let's do that, is equal to right. Number of, first the text, followed by the number of characters. Basically we'll do a mathematical operation. This minus this. And we got the surname Joe's correct. Let's see if we get the other names correct. And we have got all the surnames out. So that was a simple way of taking out the name. But do keep in mind, when we work in Excel, your problem may be a unique combination of functions which are required. Here we solved it using two functions, the write function and the length function, along with the find function. But you may have to use another set of combination. But the logic is what we're trying to develop here. So let us now go to the next function. I've used test data, just I prepared it so that we don't waste time planning how we'll go about doing it. Let me show you a replace function. How does replace function work? So we basically use write here. So let's understand how replace function works. Replace function is, suppose from this text, A, B, C, D, E, F, you want to replace DEF and replace it with QWERTY. So suppose I want to remove DEF and replace with QWERTY, then I want this kind of data, ABC QWERTY. Suppose I want, what is the way to use a replace function? We'll say is equal to replace. It gives the help here. Old text is this one. Starting number is 4, ABCD. Then we need number of characters. Let's say we want to remove 3 characters. And we want to replace a new text, QWERTY. Let's close this. And we get QWERTY. Now keep in mind, suppose there were some more alphabets after ABCDF, GHI. What will happen? Will we get GHI? Or will it be same as before? Does it replace just the 3 letters, or does it replace everything after it? Let me tab and show you. it actually replaces only those three characters which we said it should replace. This has multiple applications, so we can see how replace function can be used. Let's go to the next function. It's called trim, and as the name suggests, it trims off the spaces on both sides of the text. So in this case, TTT is covered on space on both sides. There is space on this side and there is space on this side. We can remove those spaces. Sometimes when we import data from some web page or some external data, sometimes there is spaces which may create trouble. So one way to remove the space is to use a trim command, and I'm going to pull it down, and you can straight away see it has pulled out spaces on each sides of these words. But do keep in mind, in the case of HHH, it removed the space in the beginning, it removed the space at the end, but it didn't remove the space in between. Trim is basically to remove the spaces on both sides of the English word. Now let's look at value function. Suppose there is a text and you want to convert that into a number. So suppose I say, what is the value? Suppose it's a text and we want to convert to value. And I could say, what is the value of the text? Sometimes when you get text data, it may have to be converted. Now in this case, it was anyway number, but it's a number. But sometimes when it is formatted and understood as a text, then when we convert it out, it becomes tricky. So sometimes we need to use this function. The last one is this test function. And this one checks if is equal to T and checks whether a value is text and returns a text if it is so, or returns a double quote of empty if it is not. So we are going to check whether 123 T is a text. So let me tab. So it says it's a text. Suppose I put 11, it returns nothing. If I return ABC, he says ABCDF. I mean, he gives the alphabets, whatever it is, but suppose I simply put a number, it will replace, it will give nothing. If I put some alphabets, comma, some text into it, it will show that. So with that, we come to the end of this text functions, but there are still plenty more, and I recommend that you should try out some of these other things which are there, like what is the difference between replace and substitute? What is the difference between find and search? So there are many functions which we could possibly learn and explore, and I suggest that you should do the same. Thank you.